and with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to this Eucharistic celebration on the fourth Sunday in Ordinary Time. And there is one line, there is one sentence from the reading, from the second reading of St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians, that we all know very well, serves as a good reminder, sort of a theme for today's celebration. And that sentence is, love does not come to an end. Love does not come to an end. Let's take a moment to reflect how true that sentence is in our life. Do the love of the people close to us, smiles of our beloved ones. Just remember again how much God loves you through the simple acts of kindness expressed by those close to you. For all the time, we have not been grateful for the love God gave us. We ask for his mercy. Let us acknowledge our sins, prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Lord have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
for the repose of Alberto Cordero and Epifanio Oreco Visita Arcalesa. And we'd also like to give thanksgiving for the birthday of Sofia Serrano Lupina Oreco. I also would like to pray for the birthday of my dad, that is today. And please, in your heart, bring together all of your intentions and hopes. Join them in the prayer of the church. Let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's listen to the reading.
Stand up and tell them all I command you. Do not be dismayed at their presence, for in their presence I will make you dismayed. I, for my part, today will make you into a fortified city, a pillar of iron, and a wall of bronze. To confront all this land, the kings of Judah, its princes, its priests, and the country people. They will fight against you, but shall not overcome you. For I am with you to deliver you. It is the Lord who speaks. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm, my lips will tell you of your help.
My lips will tell you of your help.
In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me, free me. Pay heed to me and save me. Be a rock where I can take refuge, a mighty stronghold to save me. For you are my rock, my stronghold. Free me from the hands of the wicked.
My
it is you, O Lord, who are my hope, my trust, O Lord, since my youth. On you I have been leaning from my birth. From my mother's womb, you have been my help, response. My lips will tell you of your justice, and day by day of your help. O God, you have taught me from my youth, and I claim your wonderful still response.
My lips shall tell of your
help. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's things, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. But if there are gifts of prophecy, the time will come when they must fail. Or the gift of languages, it will not continue forever. The knowledge that I have now is imperfect. But then, I shall know as fully as I know. In short, there are three things that last: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of this is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please offer for us a recognition.
Brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I guess we can sort of all agree that there are a lot of conflicts in our lives, in our relationships, in our families. Friendships happen because of unrealistic expectations. Sometimes we just have unrealistic expectations. Because of the word should. My husband should be doing this for me, my wife should be doing this for me. My son should be able to do this. My daughter should be. My parents should be able to do this. Or if you're a teacher, perhaps my pupil should be able to do these things. The priest should be able to do that. My Jesuit brother should be able to do this. And sometimes we apply the same word to God.
doing this for me? Why is God not doing that for me? He should be doing that. How many times in our life, feelings, our happiness, our relationship is governed by the word should? I guess the word should often, not always, but often is a manifestation of unrealistic expectations we have of each other, of ourselves, of God. Let's begin this sort of reflection today by asking ourselves, what are the unrealistic expectations I have in my life? Myself? Others? Of God? Perhaps we are not that different from the people that we hear in the gospel today. Jesus was in his hometown. He was this sort of new rising star preacher returning to his hometown. The people there had heard about him, and they sort of felt that, he should be doing that thing here. He should be doing that. Those great miracles in our home village. Not there, but in our home village. And so what happened was that instead of giving God the freedom to choose how he wants to make himself present in our lives, people, Nazareth, forced him to conform to his expectations. Jesus, the son of Joseph, our neighbor, should be doing these things for us. And Jesus reminds us today in the gospel that forcing God, as much as forcing each other, to do the things that we want, it's not going to get us very far. It's not going to get us anywhere. So what can we do? Then, second reading, the reading that we all know too well, perhaps many of you chose this reading for your wedding day, about love. Love is the only way. This is the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Were fighting amongst themselves. This community filled with conflicts. Perhaps because they also had a lot of shoulds and unrealistic expectations among themselves. But Paul reminds us that love is the only way. Love is always patient and kind. It's never boastful or conceited. It's never rude or selfish. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. How beautiful is that from St. Paul? And this is a good reminder for all of us of what love means. Sometimes when we think of love, we think of that feeling that perhaps we had when we were smitten by someone. We like somebody. Love, that kind of love that we see. Ooh, this person fills all the qualities that I want. He's nice, he's cute, he's smart. Sometimes we think of love like that. St. Paul reminds us that love is the willingness to make sacrifices for the good of those we love. Make sacrifices. But we all agree that sometimes making sacrifices is hard. So where do we start? I'm going to start with a very simple lesson that I received a long time ago from a friend of my mom. It's about birthdays. That friend of my mom told me a very important lesson. She just said, on your birthday, you don't wait, you don't expect your parents to call you and to wish you happy birthday. No, on your birthday, you call your parents and tell them about grateful in your heart, all their love. And I felt that actually makes sense. It makes a lot of sense. And I tried to do that since then. I have to say I felt happier on my first day. Because that sort of exercise helps me to remember all the goodness I've received from my parents. And that fills my heart with gratitude. And when our heart is filled with gratitude, loving is easy. Making sacrifices is easy. Because gratitude removes unrealistic expectation. So let's ask for that grace once again. To be able to love, to be able to feel grateful for all the goodness we receive. Amen.
We remember with gratitude the people who have loved us as manifestations of God's love. Let us once again rise to the new of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into heaven. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the last.
The Lord is our rock and our refuge, who helps us in all our needs. With thanksgiving and praise, let us bring our prayers before Him.
That the leaders of the church may have wisdom and compassion, as shepherds of God's people, whom He has chosen as His own. Lord, hear us.
Lord Jesus, hear us.
We pray that all the peoples may work together to protect the earth, our common home, respecting indigenous people and preserving its beauty and resources for future generations. Lord, hear us.
Lord Jesus, hear us.
We pray for Catholic schools, for students and teachers, and all who maintain and promote them. May they help parents in providing and witnessing to children and young people. Faith, hope, and love as the foundation of Christian living. Lord, hear us.
Lord, Jesus, hear us.
We pray for healing for those who are sick, and comfort for the dying. For those who care for them, be filled with patience and compassion. Lord, hear us.
Lord, Jesus, hear us.
We pray for our parish community, that we may appreciate those among us who give of their time and energy for the good of all. May the Lord bless them for their generosity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, Jesus,
we pray that all those who have died may see God face to face and enjoy eternal rest and peace in the kingdom of light and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, Jesus, hear us.
All these prayers we lift up to our Blessed Virgin Mary, the Son of God, as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Also with praise and gratitude for the life, for the joy of Sofia Serrano, you've been honoring, celebrates the first day. And for my dad, also celebrates his birthday. All the wonderful people God brings in our lives. Merciful God, enrich us with the gifts at last, faith, hope, and love, that we may joyfully follow the way of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, the bread and wine is a sign of our gratitude for all God's love has said. So let us pray that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins, and by his rising from the dead, he has opened a way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant the peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer each other a sign.
Oh, Apologize for the guitar.